Morning, everybody, and welcome to another riveting episode of Quarantine Kitchen. Today, I've got a couple of eggplants that are looking just a little too ripe, so I'm using my lunch break to make some eggplant parm for tonight. What we're going to be doing is taking our eggplants and breading them with bread, a little bit of grated cheese, some other spices, and having it all in some marinara sauce. So hold on just a minute and I'll get the ingredients on the board for you. So the first thing for us to do is to take our eggplants and to slice them into half-inch medallions. This is what's going to be the basis of our layering for the eggplant parm. And really, it's the meat of the whole dish. So I'm just going to slice out a couple for you here, lay them out, and then you're going to want to salt these and let them rest for about a half hour. This will help them sweat and make them a little bit tastier when it comes to. While our eggplants are sweating it out, getting a little dehydrated, we can work on our breading and prepare the crock pot. Crock pot's pretty easy. All you want to do is take your marinara sauce and just coat the bottom of it. Get a good layer of it in there. I put about, eyeballing it, completely making it up, let's say about a cup in there. For our breadcrumbs, it's easy. It's mostly breadcrumbs. So you dump that in there. We're also going to want to add a little bit more salt, some pepper, and then really any spices that you think would help with it. I just go for the all-encompassing Italian spices. Can't go wrong with that. And a little bit of garlic spice. Although, when it comes time to start cooking, I'm going to throw some garlic cloves in there too. Help spice it up. One other piece of prep that can be done is to start cutting the cheese. We can take the mozzarella and start slicing it into thin pieces so that it can be layered with the eggplant. I don't know how to open this. All right. This is why I like going for the fresh stuff as opposed to the prepackaged. There we go. This in half, and then start going for thin slices. So our eggplants are sufficiently sweated. We've got our breading ready to go, and I've scrambled up a couple eggs since I last saw y'all. Next steps are easy. Just gotta take a eggplant slice, flip it, throw it in there, give it a little tap. And then with your other hand, place it right in there and we'll do a nice layering around. I'll show you pictures as I go. A trick I learned a long time ago is that if you use one hand for the wet bowl and then you use your other hand for the dry bowl, you manage to keep them fairly clean. We'll keep layering. And so we'll go around once with eggplant that's all breaded and then again with the mozzarella and we'll loop that twice. All right. After we've gotten our several layers of eggplant and cheese, the last thing to do is put one final layer of mozzarella on, and then a healthy helping of Parmesan cheese. This helps to bake in the top, and yeah, gives another extra cheesy crunch. So we're gonna put this on high for 5 hours or so, and should be waiting for me when I'm done with work. So I'll see everybody then. Well, this is probably why I will never have a cooking show that leaves Snapchat. I forgot to put in the marinara sauce in between the layers. So I'm going to have some fun messing with this bowl, but you at home, please remember to also layer the tomato sauce in there. Goes a long way. Welcome back, everybody. We've got a few minutes left to go on the crock pot, but it's been a long day and I'm starving. So let's see how she turned out. It's coming right apart. Not the world's greatest cross-section, but smells fantastic. Bon appetit. Mmm. Oh, I'm surprised. I thought the eggplant was a little too well done, but it's coming out great. Honestly, all the cheese and Italian spices, everything's flowing together really well. Never made eggplant parm in a crock pot before, but it came out just as good as it would have out of the oven. Yeah, could not recommend this enough. I was a little worried, but worked well. So from my kitchen to yours, happy corn.